Mobius Motors, founded in 2010 by British entrepreneur Joel Jackson, it began with ambitious vision to create rugged, affordable vehicles tailored for Africa's challenging roads. Despite a promising start, the company recently announced its decision to go into liquidation, ending a chapter in Kenya's automotive industry. This is the story of Mobius Motors, from its innovative beginnings to its unexpected downfall. Joel Jackson, Kenya in 2009, where he quickly identified a pressing need for reliable and affordable transportation, particularly in rural areas with rough terrain and poor infrastructure. Inspired by this need, Jackson founded Mobius Motors in 2010, initially incorporating the company in the United Kingdom before registering it in Kenya in 2011. Mobius Motors started operations from a small shed in Kilifi on Kenyan coast, later moving into Mombasa and eventually setting up headquarters at the Samia Business Park in Nairobi along the Mombasa Road. The company aimed to build practical no-frills serves that could handle both urban and rural roads in Kenya. Mobius Motors introduced its first prototype, Mobius One, a practical vehicle designed with a tubular steel frame and off-the-shelf parts. It was crafted by local welders and mechanics from Kenya's informal sector, known as the Juakali industry. Despite its basic appearance, reassembling a dune buggy, Mobius proved that it was possible to produce a vehicle well suited to African unique driving conditions. In 2012, Mobius Motors raised its first round of external funding, allowing the company to develop the Mobius 2, its first production model. That was the Mobius 2. It was launched in 2014. The Mobius 2 was praised for its affordable price and approximately Kenya shillings 1 million, making it one of the most economical new vehicles in Kenya. Despite its minimalist design and lack of modern features like power steering, GPS, and air conditioning, the Mobius 2 quickly sold out its initial production run of 50 vehicles. This success validated Jackson's vision of creating a car that prioritized functionality and affordability for the local needs. Encouraged by the positive market response, Mobius continued to innovate and expand its product lineup. In 2018, the company secured additional funding, including Kenya shillings 500 million from the United States Overseas Private Investment Corporation, OPIC. The investment enabled Mobius Motors to set up a state-of-the-art factory in Nairobi, the first of its kind in East Africa to assemble passenger vehicles from start to finish. The company introduced second generation Mobius 2, featuring more robust design with enhancements such as power steering, glass windows, lockable doors, and infotainment systems. Customers could also choose from different trim levels and colors, allowing for greater customizations than before. Mobius Motors continued to expand its market reach, launching the Mobius 3 and rebadged version of Beijing BJ40 in 2021. This model further established Mobius Motors as a leading innovator in Africa's automotive industry. Despite its success, Mobius Motors faced significant challenges. The Kenyan car market is dominated by used imports called Mitumba, primarily from Japan and Dubai, which offer more features at competitive prices. The company struggled to compete with these well-established alternatives, limiting its market penetration. Moreover, Kenya's automotive industry is faced a decline, with vehicle sales dropping by 15% in the past year. Economic pressures such as high inflation and depreciating shilling increased production costs and reduced consumer purchasing power. Lack of government support, whereby the government can purchase the vehicles it uses from Mobius to promote it by opting to go for the Japanese ones, also is one of the struggles that has led to the problem of Mobius not making it. Mobius Motors encountered various operational challenges, including production delays, supply chain disruptions. Although the company had ambitions, plans to scale up production, financial constraints and difficulties in securing further investments hindered the progress. The COVID-19 pandemic further exacerbated these issues, disrupting operations and affecting sales. The economic impact of the pandemic led to reduced consumer spending and strained companies' finances. In August 2024, Mobius Motors announced its decision to enter liquidation due insolvency. The company's director, Nicholas Gilbert, issued a voluntary insolvency notice appointing KVSK Sastry as the liquidator to oversee the process. This decision marked a significant setback for the company and its vision to transform the African automotive industry. Mobius Motors' journey from visionary startup to liquidation is a story of ambition, innovation, and challenges of competing in a globalized market. While the company made significant strides in developing vehicles tailored to African unique needs, it ultimately faced insurmountable obstacles. The story of Mobius Motors serves as both inspiration and cautionary tale of entrepreneurs seeking to make a difference in African growing economies. It highlights the importance of adaptability, strategic planning, and perseverance in navigating complexities of the automotive industry, as well as having the better policies to promote local manufacturing and assemblers. As Mobius Motors winds down its operation, its legacy remains a testament to the potential for innovation and entrepreneurship in Africa, paving the way for future ventures that aim to meet the continent's unique transformation needs. So guys, in case you are new to this channel, kindly consider subscribing, kindly consider hitting the notification bell, and support us. That is the only way you can just support us. And remember, we have a website called nyongesasunday.com, and this website has, it's a collection of information, collection of articles, collection of guides across Kenya and Africa as a whole. And so if you are looking for any information, any historical information, you can go head back to our website nyongesasunday.com. And you can find a lot of stuff there. We have just a lot of stuff for you to read there. Guys, subscribe to this channel and make sure that whenever we produce a new video, you will be there to support us. So that it is just enough that we can ask from you guys. And Thank you so much, guys, for being here, and we really appreciate your support. So, see you in